which we are going to do is the damping. So damping is a mechanism which results in dissipation of energy. So here the energy is decreased, continuously dissipated, and the oscillations ultimately come to an end. So the damping is actually a very complex phenomena and it may involve many factors. Okay, so just like if we are taking the example of mechanical oscillator, the damping may be due to viscous drag of the air, whereas the friction, or it may depend on the structure. So it is generally very difficult to predict the nature of the damping. So we mostly rely on the experience that generally the viscous drag is the most important factor, whereas friction is another factor, whereas structure has least effect on the damping. So it is found that the viscous drag is directly proportional to velocity, okay, provided the amplitude is small. If the amplitude is small, then the viscous drag is proportional to velocity. So it means if the viscous drag retards the motion, then the viscous drag is called a resistive factor. So this is the main resistive factor. So this is the case of the mechanical oscillator. If we are taking the case of electrical oscillator, the energy may be dissipated due to the presence of resistance in the circuit, and also it is dissipated due to the emission of the electromagnetic waves. So if we are taking the case of mechanical oscillator, when the oscillator vibrates in viscous medium, the waves are produced, just like you have seen in the tuning fork experiment. So tuning fork or the string produces sound waves because they vibrate. So it means if the viscous drag is retards the motion and it is proportional to the velocity, then the damping factor, or we can say resistive force, we can say, or the damping force, it must be proportional to the velocity. Velocity term is dx by dt. So the FD, the force, should be proportional to the dx by dt. So when we are removing the proportionality sign, we are taking